You got a new toilet? Let's go. Because I have not talked to you about your new toilet yet.
Yo, I got a toilet that can flush golf balls.
Oh, come on, man. Come on.
Like, you walk through the toilet aisle at, like, Home Depot or Lowe's or whatever.
Right. There's a lot of options when it comes to toilets.
I mean, there's probably, like, 30 toilets there.
It's almost overwhelming. Like, you feel like every toilet's the same. They do the same thing. Not true, though, because it's been a while since I toilet shopped. It's been, like, a decade since I toilet shopped.
Like a beacon of light in the darkness of toilet shopping, my friend.
Did you just go to, like, the end of the aisle and say, give me the most expensive
toilet? No. It's not even the most expensive one.
Okay, tell me about the most expensive one, though.
I don't know what that thing does.
Full bidet,
yeah,
full remote controls.
It probably has a hand that comes out and let me wipe you.
I don't know if there's a wiping hand you can get on a toilet.
I don't know that.
How impressive would that be if there was a wiping hand? Oh, my gosh, I'd use it all the time.
So, anyways, I look up, and one has, like, a display and a picture of them dumping golf balls into the toilet. It's like, there it is. Got to take that one home. It's like I was meant to see it. It was meant to be there for me.
Like a bucket of golf balls in the toilet?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
my.
Yeah.
Like, were you looking at the mass of golf balls they dumped in the toilet thinking, that's no human can make that amount of brown golf balls in the toilet? Like, was it an overwhelming amount of golf balls?
I mean, even on a bad day, I couldn't even get to that level.
Wow. And those golf balls are rock hard golf balls,
Yeah.
Nothing like that is ever going to come out of your body. A bucket full of golf balls.
I would have to be out in the yard eating rocks or something.
I think we should try it out. I think you should go on a strictly backyard rock diet for the next week. To see if you can poop brown golf balls.
Dude, I had a dumb dog growing up that ate rocks and would have to poop them out. I mean, it's hilarious to me because, like, I was, like, eight, and, like, that's, like, one of the main things that stuck in my head about this dog.
Was that it ate rocks?
Yeah, that it had to poop them out, and it's just, like, the dog's hunched over in the backyard for, you know, 10 minutes pooping a rock out.
Hey, speaking of eating rocks, who was our science teacher growing up in junior high? Was it Miss Fody, who always had the joke?
Yes.
What's big, red, and eats rocks? A big red rock eater. Isn't it weird the things that stick with you through life? Like junior high, I remember, or maybe it was high school. I don't remember.
No, Miss Fody was junior high.
Was it junior high?
Yeah, I remember
Miss Fody, our science teacher, always dropping that joke on everybody.
I mean, she had like crazy eyes.
What's big, red, and eats rocks? A big red rock eater. Okay, so what's brown and furry and eats rocks? Bob's old dog who then pooped him out? I'm excited about your new toilet, man. Is it installed yet?
It is.
Okay, when can I come over?
I already gave it a test drive.
Okay.
It was nice.
Everything nice?
Yeah. It's like a...
Right.
You know how the ones that like work, how it's like a jet? And then it sucks whatever down?
Well, most public toilets, I feel like, have like a powerful flush to them.
Well,
you know what I'm saying? Like if you go to the bathroom in like the airport,
it just
suction power, I don't know, the pipes, whatever, it just goes. Is that what your toilet's like now?
No, it's like a trap door.
What do you mean a trap door?
You like hit the handle and all of a sudden it's just like real quick.
Everything goes away?
Yeah, but it's not like a whoosh like the scary like...
Wow!
It's like... And then trap door and then...
Your new toilet does not whoosh?
No, uh-uh.
It whoosh!
Maybe that's how you eat the golf balls. I don't know.
So it just like drops everything. Like the water and the contents of the... It's all gone?
It all rushes at whoosh. Once. Yeah.
Whoosh! Just one big whoosh,
yeah,
like a trap door. It's like a magic
off.
Trick. Round, hard magic trick. Golf ball size magic trick.
Now you don't.
I can't wait. I mean, you got to invite me over. Let's eat some bad stuff this morning.
Dude,
let's get nasty
part,
with it. I want to come over and try your toilet.
It's chair height too. Like I got one that's tall.
Oh my gosh, man! It's made for me. Oh, you're my best friend. You are my best
Greatest
friend.
Greatest toilet ever.
Bob got a new toilet.
Natalie tweets us here. I flushed my phone down a toilet at KeyBank Pavilion years ago. I tried to grab it before it disappeared. Mm. That was a bad idea.
You gotta just let it go. You can't go in after it.
Yeah, most public toilets.
Oh God.
They have the whoosh flush, where if you drop something like while you're flushing, and no chance.
No
saving
There's
no chance that thing is like circling around. That whoosh, it's gone. I can't believe, though, like, where did you get a new toilet at, though? Is this for, like, your main bathroom? Is this for the bathroom in, like, your master suite? Like, your specific toilet, you and your wife's toilet?
Yeah, yeah, it's in our bedroom.
Okay, so this is the toilet you use the most.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't believe you didn't go completely top-notch, man. Like, we talk so much about...
Dude, I got one that flushes golf balls.
Listen, I know that you... I know it can... I know it has the flush power. I know that... It has the flush power. Well, we've talked so much about toilets on the show before that I figured the next time one of us had to purchase a toilet, we would get the most insane toilet on the market. Like a bidet that squirts you, like half toilet, half bidet that does the water cannon right in your butt. I'm proud that you can flush brown golf balls now, but part of me just wishes you had the squirt, man. I want your backside to be as clean as possible. And like you said, too, it'd be nice if you could get some sort of robotic arm to wipe you. Heated toilet seat?
It might be an add-on, you know?
Oh, my God.
I wasn't ready for it
yet. Does it play music?
No.
I bet you can find a toilet that plays music. Hey, it's 2017. What are we doing here? As a society, I bet there's a toilet that plays music.
A Bluetooth toilet?
Oh, my gosh. A Bluetooth toilet would be amazing, wouldn't it? Do you use your phone when you're on the toilet?
Play it out of the bowl?
Like, that's what I do.
Yeah, yeah.
I bet the sound would be amazing if there were speakers in the toilet bowl. So when you sit down on the toilet and you know you're going to do work, like we all use our phones on the toilet. If you say no, you're lying out of your ass, right? We all use our phones on the toilet. It might not be every time we sit down and go to the bathroom. But I'd say for most of us, if we're on the toilet, we're looking to kill some time. You get your phone out if you're going to be there in a little while.
Sure.
Hey, scroll through Twitter or something. Maybe play a game. Check your emails. How amazing would it be if there was a toilet that had a Bluetooth speaker in the toilet bowl? Imagine the acoustics when your butt cheeks combined with the toilet bowl just like muffled the sound. It'd be amazing sounding, wouldn't it? Cody tweets us here, my grandma's toilet's like a foot off the ground and 2 feet in front of a tub. I'm a big guy. Yeah, wow. All right, well, yours is a little higher then, right, Bob? Like, yours is not low at all. Yours is real high off the ground. What do you say, like 2-3 feet off the ground maybe? You got some lift to your toilet
it's
now?
It's called chair height, yeah, yeah.
Wow, man. And now, are you still using your squatty potty with the new toilet,
yes,
too?
Yes, come on.
Okay, the squatty potty is that little stool that you use to go to the bathroom with.
Yeah, hell yeah.
It helps everything. I got to be honest, we doubted the powers of the squatty potty. We thought it was just like a... like a scam. Squatty potty, ever since we've been talking about it on the show, like, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 months ago we were talking about squatty potties.
Right, right.
They mailed us 2 of them. I've been using mine ever since. It's one of the most amazing $20 investments you can make.
I mean, it takes a little while to get used to because you just got to figure out, like, this feels weird.
It's like you're pooping with your feet up on this little, like...
And then your pants are up, too, and...
Yeah, yeah.
It's kind of weird at first. But
yeah, I'm a squatty potty pro now,
oh,
though.
Oh, my God.
Man, I'm so proud of you. Got a new toilet. Now we just need to get a Bluetooth speaker in that, and then we are good to go. By the way, speaking of toilets, well, I mean, it finally happened. Welcome to the show, new sponsor of our show here. Welcome, Matt Mertz Plumbing. Welcome, Matt Mertz Plumbing aboard.
Wow.
To the Mikey and Bob show, right? I mean, haven't we been talking for years about getting Matt Mertz on board with our show? And now there you go. I don't know if you're ever going to need them in your master bedroom, Bob, but with your toilet.
I should dedicate my toilet to them, like put a plaque up or something.
the Matt Mertz toilet.
Yeah, yeah. This thing flushes golf balls, it should say under it.
Okay, well, there you go. If you ever have any plumbing needs, call Matt Mertz or go to matt-mertz-plumbing.com. I agree. You need a Matt Mertz plaque in your bathroom just to commemorate your new toilet that flushes golf balls.